Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm Luca Cole.
And I'm Owen Kane.
Today is Friday, February 25th, 2022. Today is a B-Day. This week we are featuring a segment on Mrs. Knowles' class at Center School.
They are participating in the Blankets of Hope and Kindness workshop. We are also featuring a student in the spotlight, a passion project, and Spirit Week.
We are excited to welcome you back to a live theater at Hampton Academy. This year's Hampton Academy Players production of Bedtime Stories, as told by our dad who messed them up, will be open to Hampton Academy students and their friends and families. Ticket sales will be limited, so pre-ordering is encouraged. Tickets may be $6 for cast and crew members and at lunches after February break. Social distancing rules will be enforced and masks are encouraged.
Live performances are Thursday, March 17th at 4 p.m., Friday, March 18th at 7 p.m., and Saturday, March 19th at 7 p.m.
Today's intro animations for the Shark News segments are as follows. The weather intro created by Catherine Carroll. The birthdays intro was made by Anthony Westbrook. And the student spotlight intro was made by Anna Nato.
This week, four Shark News members had the opportunity to visit Miss Knowles' second grade classroom at Center School and visit Miss Knowles and some of her students.
The students are participating in Blankets of Hope Kindness Workshop. Take a look at the interview Nathan did.
Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with Mrs. Knowles' class, Mrs. Knowles, Cooper, and Eileen. Mrs. Knowles, I understand your students are participating in the Blankets of Hope Kindness Workshop throughout the month of February. Would you please tell us a little bit about that?
Absolutely, sure. So Blankets of Hope is a service learning project that has been spread throughout 500 plus schools in our nation. It provides students with an exercise to practice empathy, kindness, and to spread love and joy through their communities. They're going to be doing so by writing kindness and encouragement letters and attaching them to blankets. Those blankets are then going to be donated to the Rockingham Community Center in Seabrook along with their food pantry.
And what food pantry are you going to bring them to?
There's one located right in Seabrook on Route 1, and we're really hoping these blankets are going to be a nice addition for those who are lacking the basic needs and would bring a little bit of joy into their day.
Cooper, you just watched a video about the Blankets of Hope Kindness. What did you learn from that video?
I learned that they're donating these blankets to 500 plus schools.
That is very cool. Do you know how many, actually, never mind. But how many classes in your grade are doing this?
I think every class in second grade.
Wow, that's cool. And then, Eileen, I understand that you guys are now writing letters and you're going to put them on the blankets. What did you write?
I don't know what you are going through, but I hope you like these letters.
That is very nice of you to say that. Thanks for being on Shark News.
This week we have a student in the spotlight interview. Anthony got the chance to speak with sixth grader Allie about her dancing.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with student in the spotlight, the sixth grade student, Allie Salvia, who is our student in the spotlight this week. Good morning, Allie.
Good morning.
I understand you are a talented dancer. How long ago did you take up dance?
I've been dancing for 10 and a half years.
Okay, where do you take dance and how many days a week do you practice?
I take dance at Nancy Chippendale's Dance Studio and I practice on Wednesdays and Thursdays.
Okay, what advice would you give to someone who wants to get better at an activity such as dance?
I would say don't just train at your dance studio, also train at home.
Okay. And so, do you have any pictures or videos you could share with us of you in dance?
Yes, I do. It's my party.
That's so cool. You're such a good dancer.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for being on Shark News.
Thank you for having me.
This past week, students and staff celebrated warm winter spirit days. There was a lot of school spirit shown. Check out these pictures.
Miss Duffy's Shark Block, students have been putting together Passion Project. Sean had a chance to speak with one of the students, Kenny.
Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm here with sixth grade student, Kenny.
Good morning, Kenny.
Good morning, Sean.
Kenny recently did a Passion Project for Shark Block. Kenny, what was the topic of your Passion Project and why did you choose the topic?
Project was deforestation, and I chose it because when I was in third grade, I made a poster about deforestation, and I wanted to extend on that poster.
So what is deforestation, and how is it affecting humans?
Deforestation is humans cutting down trees for lumber and furniture and boats and anything that uses wood, and it affects us by contributing to global warming.
How is it affecting the environment?
It is affecting the environment by taking away the homes of animals when we cut down their trees.
What can humans do to help protect our planet from deforestation?
We can help protect our planet by using paper more sparingly and erasing what's erasable and just turning over the paper if you can.
Thanks, Kenny, for sharing your passion project and for being on Shark News.
Thank you for having me.
Throughout the past month or so, advisory groups have been decorating their door for it with a theme of inspiration for the new year.
There will be a scavenger hunt after vacation to find all the themed doors. Today we have some pictures of the finished doors.
We will add more pictures after vacation.
Do you spot your door?
Now for the weather. Today we will have snow. The snow will accumulate to between 5 and 8 inches. High temperature will be 32 degrees. Saturday we have sunny skies with high temperature again of 32 degrees. And on Sunday it will be partly cloudy with high temperature 38 degrees.
This week we have three weather photos. We have sunset by the beach sent in by Sydney Heaston. Moon at the beach sent in by Anthony Domenico. And sunset on the beach sent in by Morgana Silva Cosgrove. Thank you for sending in your Shark News weather photos. You can send those in at sharknews@su90.org.
And remember, remain sunny side up.
Celebrating his birthday today is Christian Sony. Celebrating on Monday is Haley Stiles. Also celebrating next week are
Madison Sire, Casey Kropp, Azan Sheikh, Riley Luby, Sophia Edmund. Happy birthday, Christian, Haley, Madison, Casey, Azan, Riley, and Sophia.
Our fact of the day is a question for you. How many inches of Badger's snow is the colder months in equal to an inch of water or rain in the summer?
Today is International Stand Up to Bullying Day. It is a day which encourages people to wear a pink shirt and take a public stance against bullying.
The day also shares how to recognize the signs of bullying and finds ways to prevent it.
Bullying is defined as unwanted, aggressive behavior that involves a real or perceived power imbalance.
Another core element of bullying is the high likelihood of repeating bullying behaviors.
Bullying does not just affect the person on the receiving end. This kind of behavior affects the bullies themselves,
as well as those who witness it.
Many students and staff wear pink shirts to demonstrate solidarity against bullying.
Our thought of the day comes from
Oprah Winfrey, who is an American talk show host, television producer, actress, author, and a philanthropist.
She said, "Turn your wounds into wisdom." Oprah Winfrey.
This week's joke was sent in by Corbin and James.
Hey, Corbin.
Hey, what?
What do you call a monkey on a minefield?
I don't know.
A ba-boom!
Our answer to the fact question is you need 10 inches of average snow to equal 1 inch of rainwater.
Remember, before you speak, text, chat, or post, ask yourself, is it kind, is it true, and is it necessary? And remember the Academy way.
Manage yourself, act responsibly, and respect yourself and others.
Go out there and make it a great day.